In my last episode, I talked about the basic drone setup to get your drone to fly to waypoints and perform tasks at each location. The challenge I left you with, and that many others have reported, is experiencing difficulty getting a drone to spin on its axis if it gets misaligned with a desired location, like a docking connector, or even at a mining site. Well, we've cracked the code in this video and devised a simple mechanism without any scripts to reliably dock to a station or ship regardless of how it's oriented in space. So connectors and other blocks that exist on grids have a very nice X, Y, and Z orientation, which is extremely convenient for aligning a drone and performing a docking maneuver. But the world isn't perfect, and this can be particularly true with space engineers and the operation of drones. For any number of reasons, a drone can get out of this perfect alignment with a grid. It can happen because you sent it off to mine ice, and in the process, it got a little askew for its return trip home. Perhaps the recoil of some weapons knocked it a little, or maybe even it's just traveled a long distance between two points where it just didn't arrive aligned with where you wanted it to dock. The same thing can happen with the dock itself. What happens if your docking point is on a ship out in space somewhere? What is the correct alignment? Your ship or space station might be relatively still, but exactly how is it oriented in this bit of unknown? Well, this method should help with solving all that, and is a simple universal solution to ensure correct alignment and orientation. If you didn't see my prior video on drones, then it's probably a good idea to watch that after this one to get a handle on the basics of how to establish and set up waypoints and actions. And it also keeps me from repeating a lot of that here. So let's jump right into the setup and you can see how it works. Here I have a drone and it's docked to an interior wall of this hangar bay. It's a welder drone, and what I'd like to do is to take it out and do some remote control welding at a location. Then activate its autopilot and have it return to the hangar and either dock itself or let me refill it with components, whatever I need. Now, when this drone returns to this hangar, it could come from any side. It might even be sideways relative to the floor of the hangar. Really, just about any orientation you can imagine, because I'd be using the drone at just about any location. After several rounds of testing, I was able to do this with one remote control block and no timer blocks. Another interesting feature of this method is that I was able to position the remote control block just about anywhere on the drone. In my last video, I recommended positioning the remote control block centered over the connector for the easiest setup of docking, and I still do. But not every drone build easily allows that to happen. On this welder drone, all the centered areas are either occupied by a large cargo container or the welder. I can't really place it that way. So that's another nice side effect of this orientation method. Positioning it over the connector doesn't really matter. So let's look at these sample waypoints I've got set up. I set them, like I talked about in my last video, by taking control of the drone, flying to where I wanted, and using the remote control block as the source point for the waypoints. I've got one right at the docking connector that I set while it was docked. That's CW1 dock. Then I flew the ship straight forward, being careful to not nudge the drone in any way, and set a second waypoint as an approach point. That's CW1 approach. To help keep the ship going perfectly straight forward, I also turned off the connector, so its magnetic nature wouldn't pull the ship in some random direction. You probably know what I'm talking about. It can do that. Next, I flew the drone straight upwards, again, being careful not to move it in any direction but up, and set another waypoint. You can, of course, label these points any way you want, but this last one I labeled as CW1 hangar. One thing you need to do when setting these points is to give them a little distance. If you set the points too close to each other, the remote control autopilot will struggle or completely fail to perform the orientation instruction we're going to give it at each waypoint. It's also important to get these waypoints at a 90-degree angle to ensure that any drone approach will work correctly and orient itself. With the waypoint set in the drone, now came part two of the setup. The drone was going to fly to the entrance of the hangar at pretty much any angle, and that was fine. It's also fine to have the drone's autopilot direction set to forward when it does that, as the direction it's flying when it approaches that first waypoint. In truth, I don't think it really matters too much what direction it's flying when it approaches that first point. But this idea of the drone's direction at the next two waypoints is critical to making this work. Upon reaching the hangar waypoint, you want to set up a simple action to change the direction of the drone. Click Setup Action on the first waypoint on the remote control block, select that remote control block from the list of available components, and choose the direction of down. What will happen is that by setting the direction to down, it will spin the drone so the bottom of the remote control block is facing the direction of the next waypoint. Then it'll begin its descent till it reaches that next waypoint. This change of direction is the beginning of the magic, but not really. If you think about it, we're trying to get our drone oriented against three possible axes to dock. The fact that it orients itself to go downward is setting one of those three axes. When the drone reaches the second waypoint, my dock approach, you again set an action, and this time set the direction of the drone to backwards, or at least backwards for me, given where my connector is positioned. This will spin the drone again to orient the back of the remote control block to the final docking waypoint, and establishes the second of the three axes. I also set a second action to turn on the connector to prepare it for docking. Then, as the drone continues its journey backwards to the last docking waypoint, that last waypoint is setting the final of the three needed axes. So with this method of setting the waypoints at straight 90-degree angles and manipulating the direction of the drone, this can work in any situation. Even if you're flying around in a ship in space and sending your drone back to a base to get supplies, all you'd have to do is set the three new waypoints with these simple actions, and it should return right back to your location. You can see one demonstration here where I have my drone above and off to the side of that first waypoint, and its approach is tilted down and off to one side and coming in at an angle. But this method self-corrects the rather random approach and allows the drone to redock exactly where I want. Even in a more extreme test, I can have the drone come in upside down and again tilted in various directions, but it does right itself, get aligned, and properly dock. One thing that does help in terms of how to set the remote control block on your drone is to have it sort of right side up, so the directions you set in the block's actions make sense. The little eyeball on the block is considered the front, and the line leading up through the slanted part represents the top. It makes intuitive sense. But it's okay if your drone doesn't have a right side up. It's a drone. It can be a blob. It really doesn't matter. I hope this video helped with that next challenge of drone orientation. And like I said, you can watch the prior drone video to get more familiar with some of the basic setup things. Take care, and I'll be talking to you later.